Hi, Mediterranean Living Community. I'm Elena Maganto. I am from Spain, from a small town in the mountains called Las Navas del Marqués in Ávila, which is in the center of Spain. So I'm bringing you in this video to show you some of the typical breakfast, lunch and dinner in my hometown, how I grew up. So now I'm preparing breakfast and I'm preparing pan tumaca. So to prepare pan tumaca, we just need bread. In my hometown, we go every single day to buy fresh bread that is made with wheat that is not genetically modified and is prepared from scratch with whole foods. That is the most important. So this is fresh bread from this morning. So what I've done is I have cut one piece like this, and I have toasted in a pan, and after it's toast, or you can do it in a toaster. So what we do is that we take a tomato. So look at this tomato. This tomato is from one of my best friend's father's farm, and I always say the ugliest the tomato, the healthiest the tomato. This is not genetically modified, transgenic. This is a very healthy, juicy tomato. So then basically what you do after you toast the bread, you take the tomato, you can puree the tomato in a blender, or you can just rub it like this. So you get all the juice and the pulp on it. Whew! And taking a shower with the tomato. So you see we have the tomato in there. And then the most important ingredient in a Mediterranean diet is the olive oil. So when we're using olive oil in the raw form, we always use extra virgin olive oil, and it's really rich in fatty acids, which are anti-inflammatory. It's why olive oil is one of the healthiest fats in the Mediterranean diet, and it's shown there are a lot of scientific studies proving that olive oil is really good for longevity. We want to live longer. So we just put the tomato and then we put a little bit of olive oil. This is up to taste, if you like it stronger or not. And this is it. And of course, in a Mediterranean diet, what we always have with the breakfast is coffee. So this is a coffee. It's black coffee, organic coffee, espresso that is made in an Italian coffee maker. So every day we buy fresh bread and prepare fresh coffee in espresso. So welcome to my mom's kitchen.
Hi.
Today is Sunday, and usually Sundays in Spain we prepare something different, something special. So today we are preparing paella. Paella is one of the most typical dishes in Spain, and it's coming from Valencia, which is in the east part of Spain. So we are gonna prepare paella with seafood. So I'm gonna take you through the process. So maybe you wanna give a try to the paella. So the first thing that we usually do, we have to boil crabs. So as you can see, they are still alive. My mother is freaking out because they are gonna escape. Let's see. So we are gonna boil the crabs for a while in this water, and then the secret for a real paella is that we are gonna cook the rice in the water that has been cooked with the seafood. So we are gonna prepare first a seafood broth, and that is what is gonna give the super tasty flavor to the paella. So for the seafood broth, we went to the fish market. We get fresh fish every single day from the ocean in our market. And I live in the center of Spain, but still every day they are bringing the fish with the trucks. So we got mussels, calamari, clams, and shrimps. And very, very important, the shrimps need to have the head, because that is what is giving the flavor. And here we have the calamari. So we are gonna prepare a paella that is for 6 persons. So we are gonna use 3 glasses of rice. So for 3 glasses of rice, we are gonna use 8 to 9 glasses. No, for, yeah, 8 to 9 glasses of seafood broth. So basically, we are gonna clean the seafood and we are gonna boil it in there to make the broth. So this is what you do to make the broth. So we peel the shrimps and then take just the head and the skin. We put the clams, a couple of pieces of cod, and then boil it for 10 minutes. And here we have already the crabs that were cooked for 5 minutes. So while my mom is preparing the seafood broth, this is what we are doing. We have here the typical paella pan that is perfect for 6 persons. So what we did is in a little bit of virgin olive oil, which have a higher smoke point than extra virgin olive oil, so we use it cooking in Spain. We saute half of a red pepper from my best friend's farm. And then when the pepper is a little bit soft, then she add the calamari and the shrimps all together. So now when the calamari, the shrimps and the pepper all together are done, we are adding pork loin. But if you don't wanna add pork, you can add chicken, any other kind of meat, or just make a seafood paella. It's not a must, it's optional. It's because it's adding an extra flavor. So this is the pork loin that we have added. So we have added about 1.5 cups of pork loin. And now is when you rectify with salt. So of course, I asked my mom, how much salt are you adding? And then she said, well, just by eye, that's the typical mom's grandma's protocol. But I think it will be about 2 teaspoons of non-refined salt. So in this case, we have used sea salt. And now we are about to do something very, very important. So when the pork or the chicken is already cold, this is the time to add the seafood broth. So look what she's doing. So in the paella pan, we put a strainer like this, and then she's straining the broth directly on top of. So the broth has been cooking for about 30 minutes, and now we are gonna add the secret ingredients. So the other secret ingredients is 1 teaspoon of turmeric. Turmeric is one of my favorite roots in the Mediterranean to decrease inflammation. So actually she has added a couple of teaspoons, and then the most popular paella spice is the saffron. Saffron, this is a little envelope that is about maybe 1/2 teaspoon of saffron. This is in powder. Look, the color is so good. No, it's less, it's yeah, maybe 1/4 teaspoon saffron. So we are moving everything together. The saffron is not optional, it's a must in a paella because it's what is really changing the flavor. And now after we mix up all the spices is when we add the rice. So we are gonna add 3 glasses of rice. So this has to be the same glass that you have used to measure the broth. So for 6 persons, 3 glasses. We move it well. How long we cook it? ¿Cuánto tiempo?
10 minutes.
10 minutes. After 10 minutes boiling, then we add the mussels. These mussels were not cooked. We just wash them and we are gonna add them. So we cook them together with the rice. Oh, it looks so yummy. And we add now the crabs as well that we have cooked earlier. But even if they are cooked, they are gonna add extra flavor to the paella. So we just spread the crabs all over the paella. And when we put all the crabs, we are gonna leave it cooking for another extra 10 minutes. All right, so now the paella is done. As you can see, the rice absorbed all the broth. So now we are gonna turn off the heat and we are gonna let it sit for 5 minutes, but we are gonna cover it with a cloth. So paella is ready. Now we are preparing dinner, a very typical Spanish dinner or a tapa, which is a Spanish omelette. Here in Spain, we usually don't eat omelettes for breakfast. We usually have it for dinner or as a tapa. And Spanish omelette is one of the most typical Spanish dishes that is made with eggs, potato, salt, and onion. Onion is optional because a lot of people don't like the Spanish omelette with onion. So here is my mom
Hola.
preparing the Spanish omelette, and we are using eggs from our neighbor's farm, so this is local. We are using not sweet onions, this is regular onion. We are gonna use some sea salt, non-processed salt, and of course the magic olive oil and white potatoes, not sweet potatoes. And here she has been peeling the potatoes, as you can all see. So the secret for the Spanish omelette is that you need to cut the potatoes this thin. So how many cuántas patatas para una tortilla? How many potatoes for one omelette?
Cuatro.
So 4 potatoes for one omelette. So she has been cutting 4 potatoes
Cuatro patatas medianas.
this thin, like medium-sized potatoes, this thin, and then some onion. And now she's heating up the oil in a big pan. And whenever the oil is very, very hot, is when we are gonna be adding the potatoes. So we add all of it. Careful not to burn yourself because it's very hot. And then we are gonna leave it cooking. You don't wanna get the potatoes crispy. They need to cook for a while until the potatoes are all well done and very, very soft. While the potatoes are cooking, it's very important that you start mashing. Whenever they start getting soft, you start cutting the potatoes like super, super tiny until we get very small pieces of potatoes. All right, so after 30 minutes cooking the potatoes, you can see that these are very, very soft and very, very tiny. So it is time to add the potatoes to the eggs. So my mom has been beating 5 eggs and she added the salt. And now we add the potatoes into the egg. And she's mixing. And now we add the potatoes in the pan. So we have the pan with just a little bit of virgin olive oil. We add the mix to the pan and we are gonna let it cook in high heat one of the sides and then we will flip it. After 3 to 4 minutes, now we are ready to flip the omelette over. This is the most tricky part of the Spanish omelette. Let's see. Yeah, nice. Nice. She got it. So now we are gonna cook the other side for another 3 to 4 minutes. Depends how well done you like it. So we are done with the dinner. We have our beautiful Spanish omelette, and we are gonna eat the Spanish omelette with some gazpacho, which is also really typical in summer. It's made with tomato, cucumber, onion, garlic, and olive oil and peppers. And of course, we have to eat a salad, and the dressing is just vinegar, olive oil, and salt. And that's it. So give it a try, and yeah, I hope you enjoy it. And now we are ready to eat.